So the next aspect is International Union for Conservation of Nature. So there I have explained about the external, like ex situ conservations in the national parks and biodiversity reserves. There we would be discussing about various aspects in the later on sections. But as of now, if you see, we would be discussing related with International Union with Conservation of Nature. It is one of the important NGO, clear, at the international level, which would be having an eye on conservation and sustainable use of natural resources for the conservation of nature. And this particular IUCN would be releasing a red list. Hope you know about the red data list, red book or red list. So those animals which are present under this particular category, so this red list is very much important. So that red list would be released by IUCN. It would be placing different species in different regions. When from different regions, when they are calculated, those different species are kept under this particular red list, and they would be categorized under this particular aspect. Clear? So red list would be in this way. Either they would keep that particular fauna in extinct category or extinct in wild, critically endangered, endangered, vulnerable, near threatened, least concern, data deficient and not evaluated. So whenever we would be reading, try to focus on these three: vulnerable, endangered, critically endangered. So those species which are falling under this particular category, that is critically endangered, endangered and vulnerable list. So you try to focus upon those particular aspects, because maximum chances of questions would be coming from those particular sections. Like, we would focus mostly on this. If you see critically endangered mammals, so whenever you see critically endangered, first try to focus upon all the critically endangered, then try to focus upon the endangered list. Clear? If you see Himalayan brown or red bear, clear, its distribution you can see. It is present in Nepal, Tibet, North India and North Pakistan. So this is under critically endangered list according to the IUCN. So the major threats for this particular mammal is loss of suitable habitat and persecution by the humans. So you do remember this Himalayan brown or red bear. Direct questions may come from this. Like, they might ask you which of the following are critically endangered, or they might ask you if you want to see Himalayan red or brown bear, which of the following sites are best possible sites to visit. So any kind of such intimated questions might be coming in the examination. Clear? So the next one is pygmy hawk. It is world's smallest wild pig. The species construct a nest throughout the year, and it is one of the most useful indicators of management status of grassland habitats. Clear? Habitat is relatively undisturbed tall terai grasslands. Wherever you would be finding terai grasslands, you know about the terai region in geography. While reading about the Great Plains, you might have heard about these terai grasslands. So around that particular terai grasslands, this particular pygmy hawk would be present. So you try to remember this pygmy hawk as well. Next is Andaman white-toothed shrew. It was in news, like it was in news, and it is endemic to South Andaman group of islands. See, these kind of endemic species are very, very important. So whenever you try to focus upon this, you please focus upon this endemic species mostly, which fall under critically endangered. Clear? So it is mostly found in South Andaman islands of India. Next one, Kondana rat. Clear? Distributions known in the small Sinhagad district near Pune in Maharashtra. It was also in news. I have only brought up with those particular species which were present in the news. Apart from that, if you feel more species have to be read, you can refer Shankar IAS, you can refer PMF, or you can refer any of the materials which are available in the market. So large rock rat, this is also important. Its habitat is known only from eastern Ghats of Tamil Nadu, recorded from an elevation about 600 meters. This was also in news. So generally, on and off, and every week, twice or thrice, you would be coming up with different species found in different regions of India, which would be under critically endangered or endangered categories. Clear? So this is very, very important. Please put a star mark over here. Namdapa flying squirrel. Clear. This flying squirrel is restricted to the single valley of Namdapa National Park in Arunachal Pradesh. Put a star mark over here. It is very, 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 very important. Maximum chances are there that this time you would be getting this question. Clear. It is found in Namdapa Tiger Reserve or Wildlife Sanctuary or Namdapa National Park, which is present in Arunachal Pradesh. It is also under critically endangered list. Malabar civet, please put a star mark over this also. It is endemic to India. They might ask you this question also. Consider the following statements related with the Malabar civet. So Malabar civet is endemic to India, Pakistan, Nepal only. If they ask this question blindly, it is wrong. Clear? And first reported from Travancore region in Kerala. So if you see along the hill slopes of evergreen forest trees which are present along the Kerala, in the Western Ghats region, you will find this particular Malabar civet. So it is very important. Please try to remember it. Malabar civet. Red panda. This is also very, very important. Like, it is very cute looking in nature. It is endemic to temperate forest. Sorry. It is endemic to temperate forest of Himalayas region, like in and around Sikkim and Assam and northern Arunachal Pradesh. This particular reddish panda is visible. It is also under critically endangered list. Clear? So this is also very important. Please put a star mark over here. Golden langur. It is also very important. So primate is an old world monkey. If you see the small regions of West Assam and in the neighboring foothills of the Bhutan, you will find this golden langur. Clear? So major threats are like human encroachments and deforestation. They are making this golden langur to fall under the critically endangered list. Himalayan white-billed musk deer. So please put n number of star marks over here, because right away from Kashmir to Sikkim, along the Kumayu regions, along the Uttarakhand regions, you can find this particular white-billed musk deer or Himalayan musk deer. Clear? Which would be having its tooth outside. So you can easily recognize this as Himalayan musk deer. Hog deer. This is also important. In and around Terai region and grasslands in North India, you will find this. So due to hunting, habitat loss, habitat fragmentation, human encroachment, so these hog deers are under critically endangered list. So lion-tailed makay, so which is endemic to Western Ghats region, it is also very, very important. Clear? So it is almost like a golden langur, but its color is different in nature. Clear? So this lion-tailed makay, endemic to Western Ghats region, so in the evergreen forestries of Western Ghats range, in and around the Kerala regions and in and around the Karnataka regions, you will be finding this particular lion-tailed makay. And in many of the zoological parks also, you can see this particular lion-tailed makay. Like, it has been brought because of the human encroachment issues which generally happen in the Western Ghats region. Being a biodiversity hotspot location, many of the species from the Western Ghats location, they have been made to reach many zoological parks, which are the artificial positions, which are like ex situ conservation methods. So lion-tailed makay is very important. Nilgiri thar, it is also under endangered list, critically endangered list. It is the largest of the three thar species which are inhabited in the grasslands of Western Ghats. So it is the state animal of Tamil Nadu as well. Nilgiri thar, along the Nilgiri biosphere reserves, you can find this particular Nilgiri thar. Clear? Next, gadial, which is also one of the most important species which are under the endangered list. So they include, so mostly it is an evolved crocodile in the world. Already a question was asked in UPSC, like, if you want to see gadial, which is a freshwater crocodile, which of the following are the best sites to visit? They have given various places across India, but the answer is along the Chambal River. Along the Chambal River, where National Chambal Sanctuary would be present, along the Chambal River, you can see this particular gadial as one of the most important species, which is mostly spread in MP, Rajasthan and Uttar Pradesh, and most viable population is present in this particular Madhya Pradesh region. Next, vulnerable reptiles, if you see, olive ridley turtles, clear, which are one of the most important. They are also known as Pacific Ridley Sea Turtles. Generally, these particular olive ridley turtles which are present, they are found in warm tropical waters. Like olive ridley turtles, they are known for best synchronized nesting in the mass numbers, which generally come on to the Odisha coast. There we have Ganjam coast, Gahirmata beach. In those regions, they would be coming onto the Odisha coast for mass nesting. You can see the picture how they are coming. Mass nesting onto the Odisha's Gahirmata beach. We can call it as Ganjam coast as well. So Project Olive Ridley Turtle is also one of the most important aspects which are very, very important. Done. So those are some of the important species which you have to remember upon with. Done. So apart from that, also if you find few other species which are in news, because contemporary wise these species are continuously in news, so I have made it as a list. So if you have any other contemporary aspects which you would be seeing in the news, please try to update them so that there are chances that you would be getting questions from there. So now we will see some of the national parks which are present. And we will try to finish this. If not possible, we will continue the national parks in the next lectures as well. No issues with it. So in Andaman Nicobar Islands, if you see, there are two national parks. One is Campbell Bay National Park and one is Galtia National Park. They are part of Great Nicobar Biosphere Reserve. So here you have to remember, there might be a chance of getting the question in this way, that which of the following national parks are part of Great Nicobar Biosphere Reserve? Or they would be asking a question in this way, that which of the following are part of Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve? Or they would be asking, which of the following are part of Satyamangalam Biosphere Reserve or Amarkantak Biosphere Reserve? Or which of the following national parks are part of Nanda Devi Biosphere Reserve? So those different national parks, when they become part of Biosphere Reserve, there are chances that they would be asking those questions. So please try to remember them as much as you can. Clear? So Galtia National Park, it is the southernmost national park of India. And if you see in this particular region, as Andaman Nicobar Islands are present, so maritime climate would be there. Evergreen and semi-evergreen deciduous tree species are found. So major fauna, no need to remember them. It is as per your knowledge. If you want to remember, you can remember them. Otherwise, who will be asking about giant robber crab? Is it present in Galtia National Park? They wouldn't be asking such kind of questions. So if you see in Andhra Pradesh, it is very important. Already this question was asked related with in 2020. So Nagarjun Sagar Srisalam Tiger Reserve, a question was asked on this. It is the largest tiger reserve in India, which becomes the part of Nallamalla Hills, as everyone know, which spreads in Kurnool, Guntur, Prakasham districts, and in Telangana, if you see, they would be spreading along the Nalgonda and Mehboobnagar districts. So the Krishna River, which is one of the most important rivers for the two states, Telangana and Andhra Pradesh, it cuts this particular reserve. And the Srisalam Reservoir, where it is one of the like 18 Shakti Pitas, which we generally call the Jyotirlingas. So that Srisalam is known for Lord Shiva. That region, the temple and that particular reservoir lies in this particular tiger reserve itself. So while you move to that Srisalam, you will come across with this particular tiger reserve, the Nagarjun Sagar Srisalam Tiger Reserve. So the Nagarjun Sagar Dam, which is the most conflicting dam between Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, has been constructed within this particular reserve itself. So as in this region, you know, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, the climate of Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, how the precipitations would happen. Here you would find dry mixed deciduous forest trees, And in this region, as usually, it is tiger reserve, Bengal tiger, Indian leopard, Indian pangolin, cheetal, sambar deer, black buck, chinkara, chow singa, mugger crocodile. These kind of species are present in this particular region. So already a question has been put up on in 2020. There are chances again they might repeat the question in 2021, 2022. So you try to be prepared. This is one of the most important aspects. If you are not going to remember about Galathea National Park, also it is fine. But these kind of tiger reserves you have to remember. Next, Kamlang Tiger Reserve, and it is also a wildlife sanctuary. So it is after, it is named after the Kamlang River, which generally flows through it. In and around the Arunachal Pradesh region, we have this. It lies between the Lang River and Namdapa National Park. So the giant in the Namdapa flying squirrel, which I have shown. So in and around that Namdapa National Park, we have this Kamlang Tiger Reserve. So wildlife in the park is similar to that of found in contiguous area of Namdapa Tiger Reserve. So elephant would be there as usually, tiger reserve, tiger would be there, leopard, stump-tailed macaque, capped langur, hornbills and flying squirrels. Already I have said the Namdapa flying squirrel, which is the most important in this particular Namdapa National Park, is very, very important. Some Mauling National Park, this was also in news. Apart from the Mauling and National Park and Dibang Wildlife Sanctuary, which are located in the Dibang and Dihang Biosphere Reserve. Here, part of Mauling National Park and Dibang Wildlife Sanctuary, they become part of Dihang and Dibang Biosphere Reserves. Clear? So, it is also present in and around the northeastern regions. Namdapa Tiger Reserve and National Park, it is very, very important. So, it is located between Daphabom range of Mishmi Hills and Patkaibam Hills of Arunachal Pradesh. Vegetation zones would be ranging from evergreen forest trees, moist deciduous. See, by seeing the location, you can justify the vegetation. Because you, while reading the natural vegetation in geography, you might have read that natural vegetation depends upon the temperature, precipitation, soil and the topography. So if I say Arunachal Pradesh, you can imagine, yes, good rainfall would be present, but elevations are high, soil is bit low. So in those regions, wherever good rainfalls are present, evergreen forest trees, deciduous forest trees, and as mountainous region, we would be having coniferous forest trees, and up to the higher elevations, we would be having alpine vegetations would be found. So you can easily guess, yes, this kind of vegetation would be found in that particular region. Clear? So this vegetation would be based on the elevation, soil, temperature and rainfall. If you know the location, then if Namdapa Tiger is of Arunachal Pradesh, you can justify the location. Done. So Namdapa flying squirrel, it is endemic to this particular park, which is critically endangered, as I have already shown you. So four pantherine species, leopard, snow leopard, tiger and clouded leopard are present over here. Other predators include dhole, malian, sunbeer, Indian wolf and Asiatic black bear. Done. So do remember this particular aspect, Namdapa flying squirrel. Next, Pakke Tiger Reserve. It falls under the foothills of Himalayas in the Pakke Kesan district at an altitude ranging from 150 to 2000 meters. If you see, this reserve is known for hornbill nest adaptation program. Already I have shown you the hornbill. It is bonded by Kameng River in the west and north and Pakke River in the east. So towards the south, if you see, the Assam's Nameri National Park on the border zone of Arunachal Pradesh and on the border zone of Assam, you will find this particular Pakke Reserve. Clear? So Dibru-Saikova National Park, please put a star mark over here. So it is a national park and now it has got the status, like earlier itself, it has got the status of Biosphere Reserve. This particular national park is bounded by Brahmaputra and Lohit rivers in the north and Dibru River in the south. So this particular Dibru-Saikova National Park and Biosphere Reserve, very, very important. So moist semi-evergreen forestry and moist mixed deciduous forestries are present. So in this region, if you see, as they are closer to the tiger reserves, in this region also we will find Bengal tiger, Indian leopard, clouded leopard, sloth, weir, dhole, gangetic dolphin, rhesus macaque, capped langur, Asian elephant and all. No need to remember them. Remember Bengal tiger, Indian leopard, sloth, weir and dhole and gangetic dolphin. Here I have took the list which are present in that particular region, but there is no necessity that you have to remember each and everything. But if you read everything, at least you will remember two or three. That is what my main intention is. Next, Kaziranga Tiger Reserve. It is a national park as well. It is a tiger reserve and it is UNESCO's World Heritage Site also. World Heritage Natural Site. Clear? So if you see, it is recognized as important bird area by BirdLife International. So when these many respective aspects are given, like it is declared as National Park, Tiger Reserve, World's Natural Heritage Site, it is declared as a bird area by BirdLife International, then these kind of national parks and tiger reserves, they become highly important for us. So these regions, generally Kaziranga National Park, they fall along the Babar and Terai belts. So they have marshy lands, like huge amount of grasslands are created. Apart from that, this particular Kaziranga region, every time when we would be having floods, which would be created by Brahmaputra River. Hope everyone know, when you might have read about geography, reading about the Brahmaputra River stream, you might have read that Brahmaputra River on and off and flows. So that particular Brahmaputra River, when it tends to flow, it tends to create floods. And because of that flood creation in and around Assam region, this particular Kaziranga National Park or Biosphere Reserve, like Kaziranga National Park or Tiger Reserve, is mostly affected. So do remember, floods and encroachment issues by the people along the periphery are most important threats. This particular Kaziranga National Park Tiger Reserve, it hosts for 2413, two-thirds of world's greatest one-horned rhinoceros. Put a star mark over here. Kaziranga National Park is known for huge amount of its one-horned rhinoceros. So they are generally poached for their horns. That's the reason why the reduction has stopped. So what government has decided is one-horned rhinoceros, some of one-horned rhinoceros, they thought of shifting to the other national park where there we have the safety zones. Done. So in this particular regard, the one-horned rhinoceros, Royal Bengal tiger, Asian elephant, wild water buffalo and swamp deer are collectively known as Big Five of Kaziranga. Put a star mark over this statement also. They might ask you, which of the following becomes the Big Five of Kaziranga? In that, we would be having wild water buffalo, swamp deer, Royal Bengal tiger, Asian elephant and one-horned rhinoceros. They become the Big Five of Kaziranga National Park and Tiger Reserve. Are you getting this? Put a star mark over here. Very, very important. High chances of getting the questions from Kaziranga National Park is there this time. So if you see, still we have many, right? So as we have very much many more to be discussed, we'll continue this national parks discussion in the next class. In the next class, we will also discuss about few pollution aspects and we will also discuss about few international organizations, CBD, Nagoya Protocol, clear, Cartagena Protocol and all.